Madam Florian Heffernan, when I first went out to Hamilton High West and we talked about what issues we're facing them today, one of the things the students felt really strongly was about issues of mental illness and mental health. And they shared how they and their classmates struggle often on the pole between depression and anxiety caused by the challenges they face at home, at school, at work, and with the interest and passions they have for themselves. And so they wanted to say something about that and about the need for every young person to find a safe space where they can be supported and protected as they grow to be the adults they're meant to be. And so, right now, I'd like to ask you to enjoy yourself at the premiere of Safe Space.
Teacher does not like me at all.
I can't focus. I'm just gonna go lie down in the nurse's office.
Third period, I didn't do my homework and I had to study for a quiz four that I forgot.
Fifth period, is the nurse ever gonna notice I'm still in here? Sixth period, and I just go spend lunch alone in the library. And I just always feel so useless. If I disappear, no one would notice at all. Seventh period. Choir.
My escape.
The only place I even kind of feel like I belong.
Oh my god, it's audition day!
Okay, everybody, it is audition day. Alright, sign this paper, put your name on it, okay? Pass it around.
And don't forget your monologues on the day you need to, unless you want the responsibility to act your speech again.
Oh my god, I don't have mine. I don't know if it's my locker if I lost it.
Well, you better get it and run, because if they call your name and you're not here, well, good luck.
Just made it.
I look good today. Are you kidding me? You look insane.
Really? You think?
Your hair is a mess.
No, it's not. I spent 20 minutes on this. Deep condition it and everything.
Well,
my outfit's big.
What about the sweat stains under your arms? You clearly didn't look hard enough at us this morning.
I guess you're right.
I know I'm right, and that's why Nate didn't talk to you today. Just get to class. People are staring.
People? This is choir. These are my friends.
Your friends? Like who?
Like
Abby. Abby? She definitely likes Z more than you.
But shut up.
And stop lying to yourself. And don't think for a second that you're getting a lead in the show. It's never gonna happen.
Auditions haven't even happened yet. You don't know anything. I'm leaving.
You'll be back. Hey, Alicia, let me show you something.
I think that everything is fine, and then the thoughts kick in.
At school, I try to bring the least amount of attention to myself as possible.
Scrolling through social media is a never-ending cycle of jealousy and self-shame.
I'm glad to be out of the hallways where people laugh at you when you're not looking.
Thoughts swarm my mind of, if only I had her body, why can't I look like that?
The choir is my favorite class. I love to sing, and I've got a pretty good voice.
Somehow, I always find a way to hate everything about my physical appearance.
Okay, so maybe my voice isn't that good.
But why should I hate my face that has seen the most beautiful sights and told so many people I love you?
But I still love to sing.
Why should I hate my body that has been here for me since day one? I can't stop my negative mind from comparing myself to girls that are simply prettier than I am. I shouldn't believe these things, but I do, and that's what hurts the most.
I have a big test that I have to study for.
Really? When's the big test?
In 10 days. But if I don't get a good grade, my mom will kill me.
Sure she will. Okay. What about you, Ed? What's your excuse?
Well, I need to get straight A's in all my classes.
You guys need to loosen up a bit. Okay? Loosen up.
If I get below an A on this test, my mom will ignore me for days. It just sucks. Right? My parents demand good grades, so I always have to burn myself up just to get all A's. The more to study, the less to focus on singing. Why even try not for the show in the first place? I go to school for an education, not for theater.
Look, I understand the expectations, but no one should go through that. Everyone needs a break, and this needs to be yours, okay? So, and besides, theater is education, okay? Focus, collaboration, teamwork. You only learn that in theater, okay? So, let's focus. This moment matters. Take a deep breath, okay? Good. All right. Let's practice our songs.
I thought we had to sing something from the show.
Yeah, I thought there was a telephone.
No, I picked my own song. Fly me to the moonlight. Let me play.
You're so stupid.
Did you finish your paper for American history?
I'm working on it right now.
Cool. What do you think the definition of race?
Race. It is the division of humans into distinct bases, into distinct groups on the basis of inherited physical and learned behavioral differences. It's a simple definition, one with definite love and passion, one that is heavily suffocating because of its ignorant figures that are attached like an eye attempt to hurry up, leaving racial minorities with few examples of that. For I am not accepted in my natural form. When I walk into a room, my name is already known. My assumed profile is based on how richly my melanin flows through my pores, how the beautiful kinks from my head decide to lay, or maybe how full my lips look. I am forced to worry whether my brother will return home or if he is dead from a bullet. I am in a world where I am being less than what I was born to be, and do you know why? Because of the simple word race.
Wow, I totally feel that. That was amazing.
Thanks.
I better start my paper over.
Come.
Nikki. Did I miss the audition to the musical?
They're running late. You got about 5 minutes.
Okay. Thank God. Thank you. I feel like my life is completely out of control. It's been like this ever since I lost my mom. She had passed due to ovarian cancer, and I found out hours before she passed away. Then my dog died. My mom got fired. My dad almost died. Then got fired from that since he survived, but still couldn't work. And more stuff happened, but it's way too much to explain. But I'm really thankful for my friends that I've made here who have always supported me and been there for me through thick and thin. And I'm just very thankful for them. And I don't know what I would do without them.
Hey, Joe, come here. Let's recite some lines together.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, Z, let me show you something.
I gotta call my mom.
Why do you call your mom?
Because of my sis.
Alright, got it. I know. I should probably call my mom too.
Yeah, before the office does.
Whatever, okay? Hello? Hello?
Hey.
Hey, it's me.
It's me.
I just
tell you something. Mom, I got an F on my outfit test.
Mom, someone threw a comment about my outfit today, so I threw a comment back, and I was the one that got in trouble.
You know that you should have studied harder.
Why did you wear that outfit?
I know I should, but maybe I need to move to class.
Mom, it shouldn't matter what I wear.
I don't send you to school to fund your math tests.
If you don't want to attract unwanted attention, then don't wear outfits that attract it.
Mom, you just don't understand. I really need you to understand my side of this right now.
Mom, why can't you just be on my side?
Okay. We'll talk about it when you get home, but I can't fix it for you. You have to do it yourself. I know. Thanks, Mom. I love you. I love you too.
Mom, why won't you just listen to me?
I am more than my grade point average.
I am more than an object that you stare at as I walk past.
I'm a human being.
Hey, I'm so glad you're here. I really need someone to talk to.
Same.
Are you okay? I'm so sorry.
I'm fine.
My God, if one more person asks if I'm okay, are you okay? The real question is, do you really want to know? Of course not. So I pull myself together enough to get out the simplest, yeah. But I know inside I'm very far from okay. But will I tell anyone? No, of course not. Not even anyone here in choir. No need to burden you with my problems. You have enough of your own anyway. But my thoughts be on. What is wrong with you? I sit still in the car on the drive home, knowing it's only minutes till my dad asks me the same question. Are you okay? And I think about saying, no, Dad, no, I'm not okay at all. But instead, I just say, yeah. Why be a burden when I can simply slump into my own corner and fade away? I'm fine.
Again, I'm dissociating. It feels like the ground was ripped out from underneath my feet, and suddenly I'm weightless. Everyone looks like ghosts drifting around me in slow motion. I try to reach out and touch someone, anyone, but I can't feel anything. Like all my nerves have been shut off. This happens sometimes, really inconvenient times, like now, here. I have to rub my eyes, I snap my fingers beside my ears. Anything to pull myself out of it. I can feel everything and nothing all at once until I can slip back into the world around me. Hold on just a little while longer. Everything will be all right.
Okay, let me go over this just one more time. I can't seem to get it right. I just have to focus. What is the matter with me?
Attention deficit and hyperactivity.
It's not just a struggle to sit still and stay focused. It's voices in your head pulling you every direction possible. Oh my gosh, I get frustrated at everybody who just tries to help me. If I don't get my work done, I'll fail school and never get to college. The voices in my head, I just want them to stop. They're drowning me and they're screaming.
Why can't you hear me? I'm right inside of you!
Okay to not be okay. Just stay with me. Hold on.
Just a little while longer. I don't just